Here we are Friday again. I keep saying every other day is Friday. The days go by so quickly. Here it is, the end of the week, the end of the month, end of February. It feels like it should be the end of November last year, but we're ready to go. It is Friday. I don't even have a clean apron to start the day. Anyway, what we're going to do today is I threw this batter bowl a few days ago. I'm going to trim it up and put a handle on it. We have been talking about teapots and mugs. We're going to finish building the teapots. We're going to talk about handles and mugs. Then this afternoon, we have the kids coming. We have our Friday afternoon fun with the kids. Then after the kids, we have to sweep up and clean up our mess in here because there's stuff going on the school for the weekend. The 4-H are here, and we don't want to leave our mess behind. Then after we clean the floor, we have to go into Milk River, into town. We have a bunch of appointments to do. Then after that, it's going to be a day. So let's get on with the batter bowl. Batter bowl, there it is. Get on with the batter bowl. We're just gonna trim it up. I've centered this and leveled it. We've talked about that in the all in the plate videos. I'm just gonna tidy this up quickly. Again, I keep talking about my triangle of strength. I'm always joined up. I always have that little bit of control there. Gonna drop that down, make my definition. Like to undercut that a little bit. As I mentioned before, I like my pots to sit on the table and say, I'm sitting here. They like to come up and say, I'm done, and they sit on the table. They have to have an attitude. Everybody needs a little bit of tude now and then, and that includes your pots. They have to be decisive. Tidy it up in the middle. I like that thicker rim I mentioned before. It kind of just centers my name and the stamp. You can hear the tone maybe. It's ready to go. No, and here's Harvey the studio dog thinking I'm knocking on the door. You go over there. Oh, he did. Good dog. He doesn't usually do what he's told. He got off the rope today and he's running across and he's in the neighbors who is the mayor and he's sniffing and he's peeing and he's going to do and I'm calling him and he looks at me and he looks at the square and then he goes, nah, and continues running off to visit the neighbor who doesn't really want him. Anyway, I digress. It's Friday, I get to. Okay, this is trimmed. I'm going to tidy it with the sponge. I like to seal it all off. So you can't tell where the trimming ends and the throwing starts. Sponge it. I'll run my finger in there and compact that a little bit and make it tidy. Put my stamps on there because it's who I am, out of the fire studio, and where we are, made in Canada. Hit my coffee cup, and it is Friday. I have this board already. We talked about trimming and working on the paper and the boards and all that in the plate video. Give it a check if you haven't seen it before. I'm just going to turn this over. Then I can put it back on the wheel. This way, I like a bit of moisture on those. I usually have them wet, but I was talking and it's dry now. So I add a little moisture to the wheel. You can hear it release. Now this is all messy. I'm going to pretty much center that. And notice I'm using the sponge to center that because I just trimmed it and I sponged it and got it all tidy. And if I use the needle to center that, I get dirty old messy marks in there again. But the sponge, you can just, it has to be just kind of centered. And I'm going to just make it tidy. It's a little freaky because you have that spout, so you compress and let go. You don't want to bang the spout. Run your finger in there, make it tidy and round. And lastly, as I look around, there it is, my plastic. I'm going to now I don't like that right there. I'm going to run the plastic. Now this again, you really have to sort of focus as you hang onto it and then spout. And one little trick, you can go backwards into the spout this way. And that way. And now it's kind of weird shape. That's better. Now it's ready for its handle. And we'll talk about handles in just a minute. It's time to put the handle on the batter bowl. I'm going to put a ribbon handle on, the same ribbon handles I used in the casserole handle demonstration. The handle I use is much more ergonomic than a big handle like a coffee cup, and I think it looks nicer. It has to be centered, so I'm going to, with my ruler, just put my ruler there, and you can see by looking down if it's in the middle. I like to do the same centering technique. You could use a ruler if you like. I just put my needle on there. It's about to there, and drop it to there. Ooh, that's much smaller. You can see you can to there and to there. That looks pretty good. And I'm going to put a line right directly behind the spout. You can also stand back and just eyeball it to make sure it's right behind the spout. Now this is going to not, as I said, be a mug handle. It's going to be off to the side this way, so I'm going to score, and off to the side that way, I'm going to score. Keeping in mind, your handle has to be centered around that. You'll see what I mean in just a sec. I always score, add water, and then scratch that water in, bringing up some slip. I'm going to score this handle as well. I'm just going to score it here, score it there, and we're going to go opposite. You can see now this center mark I have here, if your handle is a little crooked, you want it the same distance on both sides. Wiggle it into those score marks and support your handle. Now I'm going to make it one with the clay. As I mentioned before, I throw a lot of mugs and I wear off my nails there, and I have that nice sort of fat thing that blends into the handles. And just make it one with the clay. And we'll do that on the other side. I always like to have nice slidey handles when I'm doing this. I've got my sponge. And my sponge. Now this is fairly floppy. I want to support it. I made this girl a long time ago, and she cracked at the back, and she has been supporting batter bowl handles for a very long time. I'm not sure she really likes it, but her options are limited. You want to support that handle. Make sure it's all connected. And you want a nice sort of lean back with it. And making sure it doesn't pinch here. If it pinches here, it'll pinch your finger. Anyway, it's going to sit there and firm up, leaning against her, whether she likes it or not. I usually do 4 or 5 batter bowls, and she sits in the middle of the table, and she's circled in batter bowls, and she's never been a happy girl. I talked about the handle being more ergonomic. You can see this is a dry one. It hasn't been fired. It's still a little delicate yet, but the handle, it just is more comfortable. Your hands can work together in the pot. I'll give this one a tidy up so you can see. Here you can see where I did the score marks. They're a little bit messy. We're just going to tidy that up and making sure that there's no messy bits. There's a messy bit on the handle in here. I don't know if the camera will catch that, but if you left it on there, that'd be really uncomfortable when you're working. But you can see this handle is a lot more comfortable than trying to hang on to it out here like that. So there's batter bowls. I'll show you one later after it's been through the kiln. This one at this point is not dishwasher safe. But there's a handle on the batter bowl.